What is up, you guys? It's Joelle. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another episode of The Best Life. It's basically an amped up get ready with me where I can talk about things that I care about. Today's topic has actually been very heavily requested and I am so intimidated to talk about it because I feel like when you guys ask for something in particular, I really want to deliver. And this topic in particular, I just have so many thoughts on that I know it can get rambly because you know your girl can ramble. So I'm trying to keep it relatively succinct while doing my makeup, so we're just out here doing a lot. But as you can tell from the title of this video, we are talking about relationships. I'm just going to focus on a few key points that I think are super important in having healthy relationships. And no, I do not have the degree, the cover letter, the resume that makes me eligible to tell you guys how to live your life, but I can say that I am in a relationship, a very happy one, of long distance for almost 2 years now. I just really want to share my thoughts on what makes for a healthy relationship, not just romantic, though this is focused on romantic relationships, but I really think these things translate to any kinds of relationships. So I'm editing this video right now and I just want to quickly clarify, these tips are really focused on oneself. I think it's a whole other thing to address, you know, what you look for in a significant other, but right now this is just talking about if you're already in, you know, a relatively stable relationship but want to find ways that you can kind of avoid unnecessary conflict or just, you know, bring about more health into your relationship. So these are just a lot of things that I try to keep in mind for how I operate myself in my relationships. Because this is so focused on self, I never want this to be misinterpreted and put and spun in a way where it sounds like if you're in an unhealthy relationship that it's your own fault, because obviously there's a ton of factors that go into that, and things like abusive relationships can come out of nowhere, and I never want to say that it is a victim's fault for dealing with abuse. So I just want to put that quick caveat that I don't want anyone to take this the wrong way, but for me these are just standards that I hold myself to and everything I try to do within my power to keep my relationships as healthy as possible. So before starting, if you have not yet subscribed, please feel free to do so. Join the J team, where no one's a bench warmer, everyone's a playmaker, and hit the bell notification button so you're notified every time that I upload. And yeah, let's just get on into the video. I have my notes here. So many things I'm trying to say. So I'm starting by priming my face with my Milk Makeup Blur Stick. This stick is literally like rubbing a crayon on your face, but it primes for foundation. So I broke my tips down into, I think, essentially 5 points. First one is to ask yourself, almost before getting into a relationship, what kind of person you would like to be. This all goes back down to identity. Whether it's being a significant other, a daughter, a friend, a sibling, just what is your idealized version of yourself? Moreover, who are people in your in that sort of relationship position that you admire? Just people that you think do a really good job with their relationships. And what do they do? How would they respond? What are their characteristics? And hold on to this because this is important. We're gonna get back to it later, but I'm putting on my Neutrogena Healthy Skin Anti-Aging Skin Perfector. I'm just gonna dab it on with a wet beauty blender. And I know this might sound a little wonky because you're like, okay, sure, I can have an idealized version of myself. Doesn't mean that I'm gonna do it, but this is based off the idea that you sort of become what you behold. What you focus on and what you set your mind on is ultimately what you become. I firmly believe that we attract different types of people, different environments by how we behave ourselves, and that's not to say that you get what you deserve necessarily, but we can do everything in our power to get what we idealize. And it can be really discouraging if you have this idealized version of yourself or of the type of person you want to be and you slip up, because guess what? You're human, or maybe you're an alien, who knows? But I really do believe in progress, and that even if you are not purposely executing the types of decisions that you would like to see, that there is always another chance. You always have the opportunity to make it better and to do better next time. Next, I'm gonna lightly powder with my NYX color correcting HD powder. But I think this idea is really important because it kind of goes back to how really easy to focus on the roles of other people and the kind of significant other or whatever we're looking for, and then we start to ignore who we are and what we're doing and how what we do is obviously going to impact our relationship as well. Priming my eyes with NYX eyelid primer. In this step, I personally look at the Bible a lot for the kind of person that I want to be, because I feel like Jesus did relationships really well, and I would love to emulate that in how I live my life. Tip number two is to recognize that only you control yourself, and when other people
start to have power over you, it's because you gave it to them. And this is not saying that everyone gets what they deserve. Again, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about in how we manage our emotions, our feelings, our decisions, because it's really easy for us to blame other people for the decisions we make. Saying, oh, they made me, or they made me feel this way, and that's why I did that. But really, as tough as it is to accept and to acknowledge, we ultimately have control over who we are, our decision making, and how we're gonna respond to other people. Unless someone is literally forcing you with abuse, threats, or like violence, you have the opportunity to walk away. And if they are forcing you in those previously mentioned ways, there's obviously abuse, and please, please, please get yourself out of that relationship. Even if something does feel like an emotional like twisting of your arm, that is also manipulation. Manipulation is rooted in fear and is really unhealthy for relationships. I'm putting a combination of light bronze and gold all over my eyelid. In that similar vein of recognizing manipulation, is someone making you feel obligated to do something that you don't want to do? Recognize also as well when you are starting to manipulate someone. This often happens in the form of threatening, ultimatums, and sometimes ultimatums are really important in relationships and necessary for making things more serious or, you know, progressing. But when it becomes a staple of your relationship that things are unhappy and manipulative, that is a huge red flag. Since you only have control over yourself, it is not your responsibility to make someone into the kind of person that you would like to be in a relationship with. Yes, we always want to help each other learn and improve, but take a long-term relationship, for example. If you see yourself in a serious relationship with someone on the condition that they change a primary part of who they are, then you're already setting yourself up for failure. So given that you only have control over yourself, you can try to do things to help someone self-improve, but ultimately you have to let them control their own lives. And they're gonna respond in whatever way they're going to, and you are only responsible for your response to them. Okay, next I'm just putting a little more light bronze on my inner corner. But that kind of leads into my next point, which is just learning to make your own happy. And I think Will Smith actually made a really great video on this. It was like on Twitter or something. Will Smith was talking about how his and Jada's relationship was struggling until they learned that they were not responsible to make each other happy. I'm putting sable on my outer corner. Sure, yes, whoever you're in a relationship with should make you happy, be able to put you in a good mood. Like, it should be fun. But if you're relying on them to like fulfill your life and to make you feel good about yourself, to make you feel like you have confidence or whatever, that is inevitably gonna fail because they're imperfect as well, and they cannot constantly be pouring into you and like receiving nothing in return. Happiness and joy is something that comes out of your own inner peace with yourself. And if you're relying on an external factor for that, you are going to have such a hard time in the long term when things get difficult or when things don't go as you anticipate. And it can be really hard to find your own happy, like your own inner source of joy that allows you to be a happy person individually, regardless of that other person. But it is possible, it does exist. For me, for example, I think that my faith, relying on God, really makes me happy. Like, I genuinely have like a resource of joy that is external to my relationships, where I can go back to that when relationships are not doing well and remind myself that there is so much more to the world and so much more to me. Okay, next I'm gonna do a little bit of eyeliner. I'm just gonna do this off camera because it's so much easier to do off camera, especially when I'm trying to talk. Okay, I did eyeliner and mascara using my NYX Epic Ink Liner and my L'Oreal Luminous Lash Paradise Mascara. This stuff is amazing, by the way. I love both of these. Holy grails. Can't remember if I said this before, but I'm using my Lorac Pro Palette. That's all the eyeshadows that I'm using. I only used 3 eyeshadows. Super simple. But anyways, okay, where was I? My fourth point is that you cannot have a relationship without brave communication and honesty. I think this is kind of a basic staple of relationships. Using NYX eyebrow gel to do my brows right now. But it takes a lot of bravery to be real with whoever you're in a relationship with. And this just comes with being honest and allowing people to see who you truly are. Because if you're putting up fronts, then how can you have a relationship that can't have emotional intimacy? I know nowadays there doesn't seem to be as much of a value for emotional intimacy as much as there is for physical intimacy, but if you want a quality, long-standing, happy relationship, then there needs to be some give and take of saying, this is me allowing you to see my full self with all my flaws and you being able to accept me as I am that allows for a lasting relationship. Brave communication also involves, like I said, being a powerful person and just taking responsibility for things. So rather than accusing and always blaming someone else, which is really easy to do, it's saying, I'm sorry, but I feel this way. And it can be embarrassing, it can be feel demeaning to just be real about how you feel about something, but that's what's gonna allow for improvement and change. When you just come at someone being like, it's your fault that I'm doing this and I need you to change because you're the one in control of everything, then you can already tell that that would not go super well. Next, I'm using my Benefit Real Cheeky Party palette and bronzing with some Hoola. But I feel like nowadays people are so afraid to talk about their feelings and just acknowledge that they have feelings, and it doesn't allow for any improvement because no one wants to talk about how they can work together to make someone feel better. And when I talk about transparency also means being on the same page emotionally, and that is in terms of your commitment level or how much you want this or whatever, and just being real, because I've screwed up many good relationships, friendships, by not being transparent and being confused and not understanding where the other person was at, and it blew up in my face. So please learn from me vicariously that just by being honest and being honest, even if you don't actually know what's going on, just saying, hey, I'm kind of unsure, I'm figuring things out, that is so helpful for guiding you guys in the right direction. I'm gonna use Sugar Balm, I think, on my cheeks today. My last tip is super simple, but that's just to acknowledge the red flags. And I know it's a lot easier said than done, because you probably all have seen abusive relationships, manipulative relationships, and wondered, why the heck are you still in this relationship when this person treats you like trash? And that's because when you're in a relationship, the red flags are so much harder to see because you don't have the external perspective, which is why I think it's so helpful to have the initial idealized version of yourself and the conviction that you can achieve that idealized version, so that you have something to compare against what you're seeing in your relationship from the get-go, and that you have a standard that you hold and will not allow yourself to drop from. And this often can result in the ending of a relationship, but it also can result in a really, really healthy conversation that allows for improvement on both ends. And I think it's really common for people to wait for things to like blow up in their faces before having a hard conversation. But in my opinion, it's okay to bring something up, even if it's a little thing, just because you deserve to be treated a certain way, and there's a certain standard that you hold for how you will be treated and that you hold for whoever you're in a relationship with. But just knowing who you are and what you deserve and saying, hey, I'm actually not being treated the way that I would like to be treated because that's my identity, I deserve to be treated well, that is a legitimate enough reason to have a difficult conversation or to end something, which I know can be hard, a lot easier said than done, but it's so much easier to notice things from the get-go than to let something blow up in your face and wait for it for a super long time. And I keep saying this, but I know it can be really difficult, but that's why it's so helpful to have friends, to trust friends who have your best interest in mind, as well as to continually have hope that there is someone out there for you that is going to meet what you want for yourself and who is going to treat you better than you could ever imagine, and who is going to see the best in you before you even see it yourself and call it out of you to allow you to flourish and become that idealized version of yourself. I know it sounds like super idealistic, people don't believe in love anymore and all of that, but I personally do, and I trust for all of you that you can have it as well in your relationships. I forgot to say what my last step was, but I'm highlighting with my Stila Kitten Duo, and that is the final makeup look. This is it. Very natural, very subtle. I'm not using a lip color because I just put on chapstick and that's all I really need. I know this was kind of ranty and I feel like I didn't necessarily articulate everything in the best possible way, but I'm hoping that you guys got the point of what I was trying to say about relationships and how to maintain your power and your personal agency when it comes to relationships, because I feel like it's so easy for us to relinquish our control over ourselves, and that's why in relationships things can get so crazy so easily when we start to feel out of control and like, you know, the ball's not in our court anymore and that sort of thing. So I just really want this to help any of you guys who may feel like you're in that situation. And I know this was kind of like a lot of tough love, like get your act together kind of thing. But I say it all with a lot of love, just with the conviction that all of you deserve to have extremely healthy and loving relationships, and it is possible. Yeah, if you guys have any thoughts, please let me know in the comments down below. If you have any tips for each other, please leave those in the comments down below, because we are a community of helping each other and collaboration. Similarly, if there are other topics that you would like for me to talk about in another episode of The Best Life, please let me know. I am always so excited to hear suggestions from you guys, and I really care about being able to provide content that you actually asked for. So thank you for asking about relationships. Again, if you've not yet subscribed, please feel free to do so. Hit me up on all my social medias, placed right here for your convenience. If you'd like to see more from my everyday life for whatever reason, I love you guys so much. Jesus loves you, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.